नमस्कार, आप सभी का स्वागत है। मैं हूं राहुल और आप देख रहे हैं पीएम ई विद्या चैनल्स और एनसीईआरटी का ऑफिशियल यूट्यूब चैनल। ये है क्लास 10th और सब्जेक्ट है साइंस, और हम जो पढ़ने जा रहे हैं वो है हमारा एक ऐसा टॉपिक जो हमारी डेली लाइफ का हिस्सा है, विच इज़ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, एंड दिस इज़ दी पार्ट टू ऑफ दिस टॉपिक। वी हैव ऑलरेडी लर्न इन पार्ट वन फ्यू टॉपिक्स, सो वो भी हम डिस्कस करेंगे। मीनवाइल आई वुड लाइक टू इन्वाइट द गेस्ट ऑफ टुडे सेशन, मिसेस गौरी रॉय, पीजीटी फिजिक्स हैं फ्रॉम आर मैसूरु रीजनल इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ एजुकेशन। गौरी जी नमस्कार एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम इन द सेशन।
थैंक यू राहुल एंड वेरी गुड आफ्टरनून टू ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड ऑल द व्यूअर्स आउट देयर।
राइट, एंड आप चाहें तो ईमेल कर सकते हैं यदि कोई सवाल आपके जहन में आता है, सो डोंट मिस इट, आप उसे जरूर लिखें और हम तक भेजें। क्लास का जो ईमेल आईडी है वो इस वक्त आप स्क्रीन पर देख रहे हैं, dth.class10@cieet.nic.in। इस पर आप ईमेल करिएगा, और यदि आप बात करना चाहते हैं हमारे एक्सपर्ट से तो आप ये टोल फ्री नंबर डायल कीजिएगा जो इस वक्त स्क्रीन पर है, 8800440559। तो ये जो है बहुत ही ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट दो चीज़ें हैं कोऑर्डिनेट्स, जिनके माध्यम से आप हमारे साथ जुड़े रह सकते हैं। अभी आप इस प्रोग्राम को थोड़ी देर बाद यूट्यूब पर भी देख पाएंगे जहाँ पर ये सेशन सेव रहने वाला है। गौरी जी, आई वुड लाइक टू रिक्वेस्ट यू टू प्लीज़ स्टार्ट विद द रीकैप ऑफ सेशन वन, so that we will remind about electricity part 1.
Yes, thank you Rahul. Sure, I'll just have a quick recapitulation of what we had learned.
Please.
In this previous session of this electricity unit. So in previous session was an introductory session of this unit, and in that we had learned about what constitutes electric current. मतलब ये electric current कैसे, क्या, किसकी बनी हुई है, या इसमें है क्या, है ना? और हाउ डज इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लो इन अ सर्किट, एक सर्किट अगर हम बनाते हैं तो उसमें इलेक्ट्रिक करंट कैसे फ्लो करती है, उसके क्या क्या कंडीशंस होते हैं जब इलेक्ट्रिक करंट फ्लो करेगी, व्हेन इलेक्ट्रिक करंट वुड फ्लो, एंड वी लर्न समथिंग अबाउट इलेक्ट्रिक पोटेंशियल। नाउ जैसे कि किसी भी चीज़ को फ्लो करने के लिए एक पोटेंशियल डिफरेंस की ज़रूरत पड़ती है। अगर इफ़ यू वॉन्ट समथिंग टू फ्लो फ्रॉम वन प्लेस टू अनदर प्लेस, then we need to give a difference either in terms of height or in terms of temperature, and then only we can see its movement or flow from one point to another point. Jaise for the most common example we use is that of flow of water, that a height difference is required, a pressure difference is required basically. So same way electric charges would also flow when we have a electric potential difference between the two ends of a conductor. So without that potential difference, current would not flow and we would not get any electric current. So we discussed about electric potential, which we are denoting by V, and we also discussed about the units of electric current, that current is the unit, the SI unit is ampere, for potential difference that SI unit is volts, and we also learned about what are the devices we use. That is, we use an ammeter to measure current and we use a voltmeter to measure the potential difference. And a potential difference is always measured across the ends of the conductor. That is, a voltmeter which we will use to measure potential difference will be always connected across.
Okay.
The way in the circuit where the current is flowing. So the current has to flow through the ammeter. Then we can measure the current. So how these instruments or these measuring devices are connected in the circuit, that is also very important. So today what we shall discuss or what we shall learn is something called as resistance and resistivity. These are two things, resistance and resistivity. Though they look very similar, they of course tell us about two similar things only, but in the chapter we'll come to know what is the difference between them. And we learn one law which we know as Ohm's law. So this is a very important law in electricity and a very simple one, and children they enjoy to learn and remember this Ohm's law. So these are the two things basically today's class we will take up.
Okay.
And like what we discussed, like what is current? So last class we also had a discussion, but again I'll just like to tell you that current we are talking in terms of the rate at which the charge flows through a cross section area in a conductor or in a wire. And we also learned in the last session that why certain things are good conductors. And there we learned that certain things are good conductors, which we call them as conductors, which are usually metals. What do they have in them that they become good conductors? That is, they have a large number of electrons which are free to move inside the metal. So when they are moved, they are given a potential difference, then they start drifting from one end to the other. And this drift we can see in terms of the movement of the negative charges or the movement of the positive charges. Like, as I told in the previous class also, that when current was known, that time electrons were not known to us. So initially, when we used to talk of current, we used to talk in terms of positive charges. But finally, now we know that current is due to the flow of electrons. It is due to the movement of the electrons, or the best term is the drift of the electrons. So how many electrons are crossing a unit area, that will tell us about the current. And it is the formula we have seen. It is current is equal to Q by T. Q means the charge, and T is the time in which that much of charge flows through a cross-section area. Now, this was also like, today we are coming to a concept of the resistance. So I have to explain something about why, what is it. So if you again try to recall that inside a conductor, this is the situation what is shown in on the screen. That is, there are free electrons moving, and electrons which are free to move, and there are metal ions. When an electron is coming out of an atom, because electron is negatively charged, so what is left is a positively charged atom, which we call as an ion. Okay, so ion is left and the electron is free to move. See, the atom as a whole is neutral, but inside the metal what is happening, the electrons are little loosely bound to that particular atom and they can move. So when you give a potential difference across the ends of the conductor, then what will happen? The electrons will try to drift from one end to the other end, and from one place to another place. And in that process, what will happen? They will collide with these metal ions, because these metal ions are quite big compared to those electrons. They occupy more space. So what will happen when these electrons try to move or drift from one end to another because of the potential difference? There will be a collision between the ions and the electrons. And some, because now you see, when there is a, that means these ions are giving some kind of hindrance or some kind of resistance, we can say, to their motion of the atoms, motion of the electrons, sorry. जैसे कि हमें कहीं भीड़ भाड़ वाली जगह होती है, तो उसे क्रॉस करने, जब हम उसे क्रॉस करना चाहते हैं, तो हमें बहुत सारे लोगों को कम अक्रॉस करना पड़ता है,
राइट?
सो आवर स्पीड बिकम्स स्लो, राइट? सेम वे, अगर वही रास्ता अगर खाली हो, वही सड़क अगर खाली हो, यू कैन थिंक इन टर्म्स ऑफ वॉकिंग और यू कैन थिंक इन टर्म्स ऑफ ड्राइविंग, तो हम स्पीड से निकल सकते हैं. वी डोंट कम अक्रॉस मच ऑफ रेजिस्टेंस ऑन आवर रोड. So same way, when the electrons try to move, they are coming across these ions, so which they hit. And when they are continuously hitting, then what happens? Some kind of heat energy also will be generated, kyunki ye garam ho jayega ye metal, because continuously hitting these atoms, electrons will be continuously hitting. So because of that, there is a resistance to the flow of these electrons inside the conductor, and this is what is we call as a resistance. Ye resistance word yahi pe physics mein it is used in this sense only, that it is that obstacle or that how difficult it is for the electrons to move through the wire or through the conductor. Okay, so if some conductor is having a high resistance, we say, then means in that particular conductor the electrons are getting lot of obstacles to move. So that is why the resistance is more. If the resistance is less, we say, then we can conclude that in that the electrons are not getting so many obstacles, and they are comparatively more free to move than a metal which has got a higher resistance. And here I'd like to know to tell children that they can also try to learn about something called as superconductors. Superconductors are those, like I'm talking of only conductors. In conductors, there will be resistance. Whatever good conductor it may be, however good conductor it may be, there will be a resistance. But in superconductors, there's something where there is no resistance. Can that also happen? And when does that happen? So I would like that children should just find out about some conductors which are called as superconductors. Okay. Now, we have talked something about the resistance which these electrons come across when they try to move or when a potential difference is given. And this is, we also call it as a resistance. So now we'll try to learn and we'll try to measure. Can we measure this resistance? Okay, that we'll try to see. And like, what is this resistance? It very easily we can compare the analogy with the of the electricity flow can always be done with water. Only for the part that in water actually moves from one place to another end. But in current electricity, it is not exactly the same. It is not exactly an electron moving from one end to another end, but some kind of energy which is moving from one end to another end. So like if a tank mein jo agar water store hota hai, so that is like a battery, means that is giving a potential difference. The pipe is like the wire or the conductor, and the faucet is like the switch. So if you switch it on, if you on the faucet, then water comes out. That means switch on, the current will, there will be current in the circuit. Now, if you look at this pipe, if this pipe is narrow or broad, that will surely matter whether the water is coming out fast or water is coming out slow. Okay, same way in the conductors also, the resistance of the conductor is that same type of thing. That is, it is telling us whether the conductor is giving lot of resistance to the flow of electrons or less resistance to the flow of electrons. Now, this can also be explained with a, I'll try to explain it with a small animation.
Okay.
If it is.
So, this is the link possible. Of that animation.
Yeah. Is it visible?
I think it is loading, yes.
Yes, I think
I can see on the screen. Open source physics.
Yeah, it is an open source animation, so we all can use it. Okay. Because now see, this is what is something like. I'll just bring it little bit up. Yeah, sorry, want more. Yeah, we can see here that these atoms, the red ones. These red ones, they are the.
All these resource files are available.
Yeah, these are actually the open resources which children can always go to those blogs and they can see, and they can also handle those. They can also these are like simulations. Okay, so they can also see for themselves. What is there in that. So in that animation we can see that the electrons are moving and then they are getting some kind of resistance for the flow of the electrons. So if children visits, there are certain very good blogs and there are certain blogs, and there is also FET, PHET, where you have very good animations for physics learning. Like what we are just talking about, children can really do those things and they can see. So that is what I wanted to tell here. Now, when we are talking of an electric circuit, then we are using certain symbols. Otherwise, it will be very difficult because everybody will be drawing or representing things in a different manner. So quickly, I'd like to show you that these are the certain symbols which we use, and children are very almost acquainted with these. Like an electric cell is denoted by a long bar and a short bar. The long bar denotes the positive terminal of the cell, and the short bar denotes the negative terminal of a cell. If you have many, then it is like this, one connected to the other, and the next one is a key. Then a plug key, which is open, that is switch is on, or the switch is off, switch is off, or the switch is on, that is open or close. then this is the wire joint, this is electric bulb, this is a resistor, and this is an ammeter and a voltmeter. So when in a circuit you see these things, children should be able to identify that what are the parts in a circuit. Another thing which I want to mention here is what happens, like how do we connect the things, like a voltmeter or an ammeter. So when we connect a voltmeter, we always connect it like this. Like suppose this is the resistance. Resistance means a load across which we are measuring the voltage. So if this is the load, like kuch bhi ho sakta hai, this can be a bulb, it can be a grinder, it can be a motor, it can be anything. So that is called as a load or the resistance. We are having a resistance here and we will connect a voltmeter like this across. That means from one end of the resistance, one end of the voltmeter, and it will the negative of the voltmeter to the other end of the resistance, and the negative of the voltmeter connected to the negative of the battery. This is very important. Otherwise, if you don't connect it in this way, you will not be able to measure the voltage. And ammeter will be connected like this in somewhere in the circuit. That is, the positive is connected to the positive, negative is finally connected to the negative, but you see how it is connected, it is connecting, coming in between, so that it will measure the current which is flowing in the circuit. So voltmeter will measure the potential difference across that where the voltmeter is connected.
Okay, voltmeter, ammeter. So I just write down all these important devices which we are going to use in this chapter. So meanwhile, yeah, let us try to reconnect with the guest. Gauriji, can you hear me? I think we are not getting her voice due to some technical issues. So
yeah, I'm able to hear you.
Okay, now I have received your audio. Please continue.
Yeah, where it got discontinued, should I repeat?
Yes. This slide was on the screen. Okay, and you were explaining these voltmeters.
Okay, I got it. So I was just telling that what happens if I don't connect it in this particular way. Mm-hmm. Am I audible now?
Yes, please.
Okay. So if it is plus, you see, only the difference between these two circuits is that here it is the positive on this side and negative on this side, whereas here it is negative on this side and positive on this side. We have just changed the terminals of the cell. Because of that, what would happen? Because of that, only one thing would happen, that is the direction of current in the circuit would change. So here you see it is in the clockwise direction, whereas in this circuit the current would be in the anti-clockwise direction.
Okay.
So because we have not changed the battery, we have not changed anything, same amount of current would flow, but mm-hmm. in this the current would flow from the positive terminal towards the negative. Here also it would flow from the positive terminal towards the negative terminal.
Okay.
So children have to be very clear about where they are connecting the battery, how they have connected the battery, and in which direction the current is flowing. So for that I had made this slide. Now interestingly, in 1827, a German physicist, George Ohm, he studied the relationship between the current, which is denoted by I, and the potential difference across that conductor. Means how much current is flowing in a conductor and how much potential difference is there across a conductor, keeping the temperature constant. Because if you vary temperature, then certain things might change. So keeping the temperature constant, he studied the relationship between current and the potential difference, and he found something very interesting. What was that? Like, you make a circuit like this where we have some good number of cells, like 4 to 5 cells we have connected, and we have a resistance. Then we have a voltmeter to measure the voltage across this resistance, and we have an ammeter to measure the current which is flowing in this circuit. Now what was interesting is that what he did, he connected different batteries. Means suppose first 1.5 volts, then with 1.5 volt battery, what is the value of V across R and what is the value of A, that is the current, what is the value in A, that is how much current is flowing in the circuit. These two things he tried to see by giving different values to this battery. So when you're giving this different value to this voltage, this battery which is driving the circuit, means you are changing the current in the circuit. Means aapne 1.5 volt lagaya, फिर एक और लगाया तो 3 volts, 3 volt, one more battery, 4.5 volts, then one more battery, 6 volts. So every time you are changing the battery, you are increasing the voltage here. What you are doing is that you are increasing the current in the circuit. So we increase the current, change the current in the circuit every time, and we measure how much voltage drop is there across the resistance R, and how much current is flowing in the circuit. Okay. And if you try to plot, or you try to plot a graph of these things, these voltage and current. Now see, we can also reverse the terminal and we can get the things in the negative sign also. Children would like to know.
Okay. So I think this call was just disconnected abruptly due to some technical issues. But this is the electricity part 2, and we have learned few things: electricity potential and electric current, potential difference, devices for the measurement of current. And yes, we have learned one important name, जो कि एक जर्मन साइंटिस्ट है जॉर्ज ओम, जिनका कि ओम्स लॉ के नाम से आप जानते हैं. और ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट होता है जब इलेक्ट्रिसिटी की पढ़ाई हो रही होती है, तो कुछ ऐसे नियम, कुछ ऐसे लॉज हैं जिनको पढ़ना बहुत ही ज़्यादा आवश्यक है. और उन्हें जब आप पढ़ेंगे तो मुझे लग रहा है कि आपका जो फिज़िक्स का कंसेप्ट है वो बहुत ज़्यादा क्लियर हो जाएगा. इसके साथ साथ हम यहाँ पर ये भी बता दें आपको कि आज दिन भर में आप कौन कौन से और हमारे प्रोग्राम्स, हमारे सेशंस देखने वाले हैं. जैसे ही ये क्लास 9th का साइंस का हमारा सेशन ख़त्म होगा, आप क्लास 10th का 2:30 पर इंग्लिश का एक लेक्चर सुनेंगे, इन विच वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न अ पोएम, अ टाइगर इन द जू. हाफ़ एन आवर की हमारी क्लास 10th होगी. उसके बाद हमारी क्लास 9th होगी, जिसमें हम सोशल स्टडीज़ पढ़ने जा रहे हैं, और टॉपिक बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग है, वो है इंडिया एंड कंटेम्प्रेरी वर्ल्ड, फ्रेंच रिवोल्यूशन पार्ट 4. इसके बारे में पहले भी आप पार्ट 3 पढ़ चुके हैं, और संभवतः आज इन तीनों को मिलाकर हम एक रिविजन करने वाले हैं, और बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट ये चैप्टर होने वाला है. इसके बाद आप 3:30 पर आज हमारे जो PME विद्या चैनल्स हैं उनके स्केड्यूल में क्लास 9th में ही कोऑर्डिनेट ज्योमेट्री पढ़ेंगे. पार्ट 2 मैथमेटिक्स की ये क्लास होगी, तो इसको भी मिस मत करिएगा, क्योंकि पार्ट 1 आप पहले पढ़ चुके हैं. इसके बाद हमारा वेबिनार होने जा रहा है, जिसमें एक लीगल एडवाइज़र आज हमारे गेस्ट हैं. बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट ये वेबिनार होता है, जिसमें हम ICT टूल्स डिस्कस करते हैं. और जैसा हम सभी ये जानते हैं कि ICT टूल्स आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन आर डेली लाइफ, वो एक ताकत की तरीके से हैं, और जब ताकत का मिसयूज़ होता है तो बहुत ज़्यादा प्रॉब्लम्स होती हैं. तो मुझे लगता है कि वो बहुत ज़्यादा इंपॉर्टेंट है, तो आप वेबिनार भी ज़रूर देखिएगा. एंड इसके आखिर में हमारा जो 5 बजे होता है सहयोग सेशन, वो आज बहुत ही महत्वपूर्ण है. जैसा मैंने आपसे कहा कि ICT का आजकल ज़माना है, बहुत तेज़ी से सोशल मीडिया है आज चारों तरफ. तो जो टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन है सहयोग में, जिसमें हम अपने मेंटल वेलबींग की बात करते हैं, वो है ऑनलाइन क्लासेस, ई लर्निंग एंड सोशल मीडिया, पीयर प्रेशर एंड कोपिंग स्ट्रेटजीज अमंग एडोलेसेंस. क्लास 6th to class 12th के स्टूडेंट्स के लिए हमारे ये विशेष सहयोग सेशंस होते हैं. बहरहाल हम अपना ये हमारे आज के कार्यक्रमों की रूपरेखा है जो मैंने आपको बताई. आप आज पूरे दिन PME विद्या चैनल्स पर ये सारे सेशंस देखने वाले हैं. हमारा ये फिजिक्स का यानी कि साइंस का क्लास 10th का सेशन हम यहीं समाप्त करते हैं. गौरी जी का बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद, थैंक यू वेरी मच, आप हमारे साथ जुड़ी और आपने इलेक्ट्रिसिटी को एक्सप्लेन किया. मैं अपनी पूरी टीम के साथ आपसे विदा लेता हूँ. थोड़ी ही देर में हाजिर होंगे इंग्लिश का सेशन लेकर. इस चैनल पर कहीं मत जाइएगा, देखते रहिए. नमस्कार.